Hello everyone, welcome to the Electromagnetic Spectrum Lab channel. In this video, I'm going to explain how to simulate a three-dimensional optical waveguide using COMSOL Multiphysics. I will describe different available solutions, their features, and compare their advantages and limitations. So let's get started. COMSOL Multiphysics offers two solutions for simulating an optical waveguide, generally in time-independent problems. One is the frequency domain interface, abbreviated as EWFD, and the other is the beam envelopes interface, abbreviated as EWBE. First, I will introduce each solution and explain its features, then we will compare them and list their pros and cons. The frequency domain interface is a traditional interface of the wave optics module. It can simulate an optical waveguide in a stationary problem by solving the standard Helmholtz equation. Unlike traditional methods that solve the full electromagnetic field, the beam envelopes method assumes that the electric field can be expressed as a slowly varying envelope multiplied by a rapidly oscillating carrier wave. The beam envelopes interface invokes a slightly modified version of the Helmholtz equation. The key differences involve the terms K1 and E1. In the beam envelopes interface, the electric field is expressed in the phasor form as a product of the envelope function E1 and a phase function. By substituting this representation into the Helmholtz equation, we obtain the modified equation that is solved in the beam envelopes interface. If K1 is known, the only unknown is E1. Since E1 is a slowly varying function, it requires significantly fewer mesh elements compared to resolving the rapidly oscillating electric field. In many optical waveguides, this assumption holds true. It is worth noting that this method does not involve any theoretical approximation. To retrieve the electric field E, the numerically solved E1 is substituted back into the phasor representation. This table provides a brief comparison of the features of the frequency domain and beam envelopes interfaces. As mentioned earlier, the frequency domain interface requires more resources such as memory and computation time to achieve reliable results, which is a major advantage of the beam envelopes interface. Additionally, the simulation setup for the frequency domain interface is easier than that of the beam envelopes interface, which requires defining the correct phase function of wave propagation in the waveguide. The frequency domain interface is suitable for general wave problems, including scattering, reflections, and multimodal systems, especially when wave behavior is complex, multiple propagation paths exist, or the wave travel direction is uncertain. On the other hand, the beam envelopes interface is ideal for modeling waveguides, lenses, and large domains, where the field direction is predictable, significantly reducing the computational load. As for limitations, the frequency domain interface has a high computational load, while the beam envelopes interface can produce inaccurate results if the phase function is incorrectly defined. As an example, we compared the two interfaces in the simulation of a bent waveguide. To achieve the same results with each interface, the frequency domain interface requires more than 25 times the number of mesh elements and takes about 40 times longer to simulate compared to the beam and waves interface. To obtain accurate results with the beam and waves interface using the minimum number of degrees of freedom, the phase function must be correctly defined. As an example, we will simulate a bent waveguide. As shown in this figure, the propagated wave in each domain of the waveguide experiences a specific phase change. Therefore, the phase function can be expressed by this equation, where R0 is the waveguide bend radius and beta 1 is the propagation constant of the input port. The structural and material parameters used for the waveguide simulation are shown on this page. To summarize, this part introduced the COMSOL Multiphysics solutions for simulating an optical waveguide. We discussed the theory, features, advantages and disadvantages of each method and provided a comparison between them. In the second part of this video, which will be published next week, I will demonstrate how to simulate a bent waveguide using the beam and waves solution in COMSOL Multiphysics. Thank you for watching, stay tuned and have a great time.